Hello students, good morning all of you. So we were on the chapter number 2, that is basic accounting terms. So for your accounts we are following T.S. Garewal's double entry bookkeeping, and in accounts we are on the chapter 2, basic accounting terms. So by going through this chapter you are able to learn the following objective: apply knowledge of GAAP, that is generally accepted accounting principles, and managerial accounting theories to business organizations, states and local governments, and also with non-profit organizations. So before starting today's topic, let us all first know that which are the various accounting terms which we are going to study, or the key terms which we are going to discuss in this lecture. So first of all, account, books of account, entry, debit, credit, proprietor, balance sheet, insolvent, solvent, book value. These terms are not very new to you people now. You people are very much aware about these elements. Insolvent, solvent, book value, investments, receivables, payables, bills of exchange, depreciation. So just tell me one thing, have you all been familiar with Mahindra company? So many of you must be having its Activa also, Mahindra Activas, Mahindra trucks, Mahindra scooters, Mahindra three wheelers, right? So today we are going to discuss about one of its very famous products, that is Mahindra trucks and bus division. Further, formerly it was called Navistar. Navistar is one of the partner of Mahindra company with 49% shares, and it's a US partner. So Navistar has 49% of its share in Mahindra, and Mahindra itself has invested 51% of the capital. So in this particular example, why we are quoting this example, you will come to know about the various terms. So while further proceeding the lecture, I'll correlate this company and the accounting terms which they often use. And moreover, this company is not limited in India only. It is serving in India, Nepal and Sri Lanka too. Okay, now start with our very first key term today, that is depreciation. We have already discussed this term depreciation in a nutshell when we were doing profit and loss account. So you must remember, depreciation means reduction. So you are having a car in your porch, right? A car is lying there in your home. So ask your father, or you must be knowing now that you are in plus one now, that the day when you purchase the car, suppose it cost you about 6 lakh rupees. And now, after a period of 1 year, say 6 months, 2 years, 5 years, whatsoever, is it valuing the same? If you want to sell this car and want to buy a new one, is it valuing the same? Will you be able to sell it at again 6 lakh rupees? I think no. Why no? Because the value of an asset which you possess, its value decreases when you keep on using the same, because that asset needs repair, some installation, some mechanics. So in that way, it is used, due to its wear and tear, its value decreases. So what is depreciation? Reduction in the value of an asset due to its wear and tear. Okay, let us take an example. Now Ram Brothers, they are very good customers of Mahindra company. On 1st October 2018, they purchased a truck at a cost of Rs. 1,40,000 and spent Rs. 10,000 on its installation. The firm writes off depreciation at the rate of 10% per annum. Now, firm already decides that due to usage, the value of the truck will be going to decrease, and that is going to decrease at the rate of 10% per annum. Now see the word here, per annum, somehow abbreviated as P.A. Per annum means 1 year. Now Ram brothers close their accounts every day, every year on 31st March. So now this year their account would be closed in 31st March 2019. So look here, if they calculate depreciation, now 1,40,000 is the cost. They will also add 10,000 of its installation. Total becomes 1,50,000. 1,40,000 plus 10. So applying 10% on 1,50,000, we are getting 15,000. So what is 15,000? The amount of depreciation. Now this depreciation amount is an expense. It's a loss to the business. So after 6 months, see, they have bought on 1st October. October, November, December, January, February and March. 6 months they have used and now they have to record the value again. Now while they record the value, they'll analyze that they will record it at 1,35,000. That is total value minus 15,000, right? So when it is recorded, it is called an account. So now we are on the next term. See, when you record all these things, it will become an account because we are recording it, all its details, along with its effect, along with financial interpretation. That is, cost of the truck is written down, hence reducing the assets of Ram Brothers. So now we have covered two items. One is depreciation, another is account. See, depreciation is recorded as follows. First of all, on left side we write debit. So whatever item is written on the left side of an account, T form account, is called debit, and whatsoever we write on the credit side, that is right side of the account, T form account, T means in this way, in a tabular form, so that is called credit. Now on left side we record date, the content and the amount, same date, particulars, amount. 1st October we bought it, so we bought it through bank, so two bank account, 1,40,000. Again we spent 10,000 through bank for its installation, so the total cost becomes here 1,50,000. Now we are going to charge depreciation. What was the depreciation amount? 15,000. Now total of 1,50,000 less 15,000, so it will be 1,35,000. Now when it is recorded, it is recorded in this manner, and this recording is called books of account, right? Recording the event with a date. So when we record any particular event or transaction of a business with a date mentioning on it, so it becomes an entry. So when we record it with the help of a date, it becomes an entry, right? So now here we have covered another key terms also, that is debit, credit, entry and books of account. Here Ram Brothers, Mahindra Group, they are called proprietors. Proprietor means owner of the business, because they are making the investments and they are bearing all risks. So that's why they are called proprietors. So who are proprietors? Owner of the business. When these entities are recorded in the respective financial position at the end of the year, and what is that financial position called? Balance sheet. As you have already done in the previous chapter, so what is a balance sheet? It's a summarized statement of all assets and liabilities of a particular company at the end of one particular year. So next comes bills of exchange. Bills of exchange. Okay, what does it mean? That you purchased goods or you sell goods. You have made a bill and now you are exchanging in between the buyer and seller. Because you have not made cash payment, ready payment, that's why you are now exchanging them. So that's why it is called a bill of exchange. Now look at one thing. This is a format of a bill of exchange, that how a particular bill of exchange is made. So on the right side we write the address. So whose address is this? This is the address of the person who is making the bill, right? And on the other side we write the date, the revenue stamp we put, and here we also write that what amount and when to pay. So look here, 3 months after date, pay to me or my order the sum of 50,000 for value receipt. 3 months after 3 months, that either you can pay to me or the person who will bring you this bill, pay to that person 50,000. Now, to whom this bill has been given? To Krishna, 25 Park Avenue, Kolkata. Krishna accepted the same. He has put his initials here. And this is also undersigned by Dina. Dina is one who is making the bill. So, now what is a bill of exchange? An instrument in writing which is made to direct a person to pay money when demanded because he has entered into a transaction with another party. Now, let us elaborate this example. Suppose on 1st April 2019, Krishna of Kolkata purchased goods from Dina of Amritsar on credit, for which Dina makes a bill on Krishna for Rs. 50,000 for value received. The bill is duly accepted by him. So what is bill of exchange now? So a written form or a document made by seller as a bill and directing the purchaser to pay money as and when time period ends. So, what is a bill of exchange? A document made in writing by the seller, given to the purchaser to pay the amount decided in between them for the transaction so incurred. Okay, now remember, who was Dina? Dina was the person who makes the bill. He was the seller. For Dina, it is bill receivable because he will receive the money after 3 months. And for Krishna, it is bills payable. So, bill receivable is a document which is made by the seller for the amount received after a stipulated date. And bills payable is a document accepted by the purchaser in which he promises to pay the amount for which he has entered into a transaction. When all the bills taken together for one whole accounting year, that is from January to December or from April to March, it is called receivables. And on the other hand, for the purchaser, it is called bills payable. Okay, now a very important term, as I have told you that we will discuss this term in the starting, bad debts. Bad debts. Debts means the person who are supposed to give you money back because they have purchased goods from you. They are debtors. Now, bad debtors are those who are not in a position to pay you back your amount. So what are bad debts? Bad debts is the amount to be received from the debtor, but the debtor is not in a position to pay you back and he has declared himself that he will not pay you because he is not in a position to pay. Now suppose, continuing the same bill as we were discussing, if after 3 days of grace, okay, now there is a term 3 days of grace. Suppose today is 19 May or 13th May, you can say. So calculate 3 months after this. Bill was drawn on 13th May, na? The specimen we draw. Bill was drawn on 13th May. So calculate 13 May till 13 June, 1 month, then July, 2 months. And then August, 3 months. On 13th of August, 3 months will be completed for which Krishna has to pay the money, and 3 days extra will be given to him as a reminder, right? And those days are known as days of grace. So now he is liable to pay the amount on 16th of August, right? But if he is not able to pay money, that is, then Krishna's amount 50,000 will be declared as bad debts. Who is the bad debtor? Krishna here. And what is bad debts? 50,000 rupees. Whole amount would turn as bad debts because it becomes irrecoverable and a business loss also. So for the company, irrecoverable amount becomes bad debts. The person who is not in a position to pay its debts, its liability, is called a insolvent person. The one who is not able to pay his debts. So when does a person is not able to pay? If his business is going in loss, if he is not having actual sales, if he is not earning any profit, then he will not be able to pay back to the creditors. So in that case, he will be an insolvent. Now, on the other hand, the person who is in sound position, one whose business is running very smoothly, he has a very good reputation in the market, his credit worthiness is quite admirable, and in that case, he always clears his liabilities. So what kind of person he is? He is a solvent. Okay, now we will discuss about next more two terms, that is entity. One, we have two types of entities. Entities means undertakings, companies, concerns. So we have two types of entities. One is business entity, other is non-business entity. So for this week, you have done so many examples and you have come across with many companies. We have done Haldiram, we have done Organic India, we have done Shri Sai Industries, and we have done Mahindra today also. So Maliram Jewelers, HUL Private Limited, so all these concerns are what? Business entities, because they are doing business, they are making some transactions for earning profits. And another type of entity is NGOs, non-government organizations or non-profit organizations. Being Human, Salman Khan's NGO, right? So what it is? It's a non-business entity. So he is also running his showrooms, Being Human showrooms, you can see. So business is going on, na? But it's a non-business entity because all the receipts goes into charity. Okay, the next term which we have to discuss is expenditure. Expenses and expenditure. Expenses we have discussed. Now we will discuss about expenditure. Amount spent to receive a benefit is called expenditure. So whatever you receive, whatever you spend to receive a benefit is called expenditure. Expenditure is of two types. One is capital expenditure, another is revenue expenditure. So look here, capital expenditure means money spent on assets. Simple. If you spend to buy some assets, then it is called capital expenditure because you are getting it, their benefit for a very long time. We buy land, we buy building, machinery, vehicles, big plants, factories, furniture. So why are, do we buy them daily? Are they our daily needs? No, we buy them once or twice in our life. So what is this? This is a capital expenditure whose benefit we get for a long time. Now other side we have revenue expenditure. For example, the purchasing goods to be consumed within 1 year. Okay, give me an example of revenue expenditure. Okay, these days as our online classes are going on, so many of the science students are getting RoboMate links. They are having smart links with them. So every year what happens? School makes a revenue expenditure. What is that revenue expenditure now? They have a tie-up with ClassNext, with RoboMate, with Smart Classes. So these are the softwares, these are the software companies with which school has a tie-up. And for every particular year, after every particular year, they have to get it renew, cancel it, buy a new one. It's their choice. But it's a kind of revenue expenditure because it will be consumed in 1 year only. So the very last basic accounting element of this chapter is investments. Employing funds to earn a return. So suppose you have 8 lakh rupees with you. Now you want to increase that money. You must invest it somewhere. So what is it called? Investment. Either you start a business, you will start earning profit. Either you buy shares of other company and you will sell those shares afterwards, or you can invest it in mutual funds, mutual bonds, because after a particular period their amount will increase depending upon the market. So moreover, you can say, okay, let us take an example of a fixed deposit account. This is very simple example. In a bank, FD is opened. your parents get your FD opened in the name of you, in the name of themselves only. So what happens? They deposit lump sum amount in bank, say 1 lakh rupees, and these days rate is 6.25%. So after 1 year, their amount will become 1,625. So the increase in amount of initial amount or the difference is called return. And what kind of transaction it is? It is a business transaction as they are making investment, right? These were all your basic accounting terms. I hope now all the terms are clear. Listen, class, go through the terms properly, because next week we are going to start with a numerical chapter. So you are only able to solve the sums if you have thorough clarity of the all concepts. Only then you can put them into use. So read the PDF. Do follow the given link for better clarity of the concept. Also try to answer the questions. Why does a liability arise? Distinguish between opening and closing stock. Also, power looms manufactured by XYZ for sale to a textile company. Tell me what kind of entity it is, business or non-business. Okay, you think and answer the same. Follow the SNAP homework. Go through all the links. Kindly listen to the school links. Have a hold on your chapter. Only then you are able to understand this subject properly. Thank you.